Hello Capcom, I've been thinking about the zombies in Resident Evil 6, and I think there are some nice touches, but for Resident Evil 7 I would like to see more builds of zombies. So some of them are skinny, some of them are normal weight, some of them are a bit fat, and I would also like to see more variations in the clothes they wear, so that if you're in an office building, maybe they're gonna wear like a suit or something. And if they're on the street, maybe it's a bicycle messenger, it's a cab driver, it's a sanitation worker, it's a hot dog vendor, and so on. I really think that it would be nice if in Resident Evil 7 the zombies were more varied like that. I really miss that in almost every zombie game that there is, and I really hope that can make it into Resident Evil 7. And also, I think that one of the things I think would be really nice was, I don't know if you can do it in Resident Evil 6, I'm not entirely sure, but I don't think you can shoot off a leg of a zombie. But if you like could shoot off a leg so that it was forced to crawl. And maybe you could even, like, if you get a shotgun blast to the torso, shoot the lower, shoot the body, so that it's only the top part of the torso that's left, and then the arms and the head, it's still gonna crawl and try and eat you. But so I'm hoping that you can do that. And also in Resident Evil 6, the zombies were. They had sort of like this black goo inside of them, and I think it would be nicer if instead of that they had, like, when you shot them, chunks of meat fell off. Not necessarily blackened meat, but like a chunk of meat, like almost a pork chop. Like something fell off like that. I think that could be really nice, and I hope that you will sort of like continue to improve on how the zombies are in the game, and make them more responsive, so that when they hear a gunshot, they will come running, and so on and so on and so on. And also that there will be more scenes where instead of just one or two zombies in the distance, you're gonna be rushed down by a mob of zombies. I think that's a hallmark of the movies, and I think that is sort of missing. Another thing I've been thinking about is it could be nice if when you like had when you were opened the door, that there was like this sort of like dramatic door opening, so that you could sort of decide if your character was gonna like. When you're standing at a door on either side, one partner on one side, one partner on the other, if you could sort of like decide that either you're gonna go just kick down the door and aim down there, or you're gonna like kick down the door and then start walking down the hallway, whatever is there. Or you could like crouch and try and shoot from below, so that in a sense picking the right way of entering a door becomes a part of the gameplay, becomes like a game mechanism, so that you have like these like there was dramatic horror in Resident Evil 6. There could be like these dramatic entrances of like doors, like perhaps a double door where you can either kick it down and sort of like rush in, or you can open it slowly and shoot from there, and so on and so on. And yeah, I think that could be really nice. And maybe you had to listen a bit at the door to figure out what is on the other side, so that sometimes so that if you get it right, you will get like an advantage coming through the door, and if you get it wrong, you will sort of like be in danger. I think that could be really nice, and I hope that could become part of well, the Resident Evil experience. I think that would be really good. And the last thing is, I think like the stances that the characters have, some of them, like you can, like in Resident Evil 6, you have a lot of improved mechanics, but for movement, you can like roll and dodge and sort of like do a somersault to the side, or like a roll to the side, or roll forward and so on. I think I would really like if you made it so that the character had like three main stances, one which is standing, one which is crouching, which gives you improved aim, and one which is lying prone, like in a military shooter. And when they're lying prone, they can crawl into narrow entrances, and when they're crouching, they have improved aim or improved accuracy, but they can't move. And when they're standing up, they can move a bit from side to side, but they can't do rolls. They can only do rolls when they are crouching. I think that if it was sort of like made so that there were a greater sense of limitation in the movements, it could add to the feeling of horror and claustrophobia, and of not being of being ill-equipped to survive such a situation as one finds oneself in. And I think that would be really nice. And last, I hope that there will be segments where you play as a civilian, who maybe only has a weapon, has a crowbar, or something like that. That could be really nice. If there were like sequences where you played as a civilian who can only maybe stand and aim and not move while aiming, or run, and that's the only two options this civilian has. I think it could be like a hot dog vendor, or I mean, it could be anybody. And I think that would be really nice, because the heroes and the main characters of Resident Evil are getting pretty good at killing zombies. And to bring back some of the horror from the earlier games, I think you have to allow the player to control some characters that aren't necessarily experienced with zombie killing. And I think that could be a really nice thing. And then if the characters, if this civilian character survives, the characters can either meet this person and get this person to safety, and maybe get points for saving this person. And if when you play as the civilian, if you die, then the characters will meet this civilian later on as a zombie, and will have to kill this zombie. And that will also add to the horror, I feel, because then it's not just another mindless zombie. It's somebody that you know. It's somebody that you have a sense of responsibility for, and I think that you will feel that you will be able to a far greater degree see the person that was in the zombie before, and that will increase the horror, because it will make it more obvious that you're not just killing zombies in a sense. You're killing something that was a person an hour ago or 2 hours ago. And that feeling, I think that conflict of wanting to save somebody that you know versus having to kill them to survive, I think that could be, well, I think that could be looked at further, and sort of like work that edge, because if done well enough, I think it could add to the sense of horror and the feeling that something is terribly wrong, and that it isn't just oh yeah, I gotta go into this room and shoot the zombies. It's all like, oh wait, I know these people, and I can empathize with them, and I can, you know, something like that. Yeah, sorry for so many suggestions, and sorry for so long a video. I've been thinking a lot, so the next videos will be shorter, and I hope you're all well, and I'm trying to keep it under 10 minutes. All right, God bless you, and take care.